Not sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous I couldn't speak. In that very moment I found the one, and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live, I love you, we'll have it all, you. You look so beautiful in white, and from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. Love is timeless, my love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word.
You are here this morning, then you are very special, because this is very intimate and this is for family. Amen. And so thank you for coming, and my prayer is that you will leave this place blessed. Amen. You may take your seats. Dearly beloved, we are joined here together this morning to join in the holy estate of matrimony our brother Eddie Dabo and Patrice Barr. If there's any just cause why these two should not be married, if anyone here knows any just cause why they shouldn't be married, please make it known or forever hold your peace. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's all friends. There's no enemy here. Amen. Hold his right hand. Marriage is a beautiful thing, and marriage is God's creation. We see from the very beginning how God brought Adam and Eve together, the first couple, and blessed them and made them fruitful and gave them everything to succeed in their journey. My prayer is that everything that you need as a man, God has put on the inside of her to be able to help you and to bless you and to take care of you and enable you to be the helpmeet that God ordained for her to be, to enable you to fulfill God's assignment for your life. I also believe that every grace to cover you, to provide for you, to protect you, to love you, to care for you, as Christ did for the church, he has put inside of this noble man to be able to fulfill your needs and your desires and to help you fulfill God's purpose. If there's any reason why you believe that you shouldn't be married, let me know before I proceed. Do you have any reason? Do you have any reason? Amen. There's only one policy that as a bishop I have in blessing marriages, and it's a no return policy. I don't want you to bring her to me, and I don't want you to bring him to me that there is irreconcilable differences or anything. Once you cross this Jordan, you are not going back to Egypt again. Amen. 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 If you all agree, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Who has the rings? This is some serious bling. Put your hands together for the man. He's done well. Stretch forth your hands and let's bless the rings. Father, we consecrate these rings through the power of your word and by the power of your spirit. We take it out of the natural and we bring it before your throne of glory with thanksgiving and with praise. We immerse it in the blood of Jesus Christ. We seal it by the seal of your spirit. Let heaven be witness Let heaven give credence to what is happening today. We invite you to be at the center of this marriage, at the center of this union. Pray that you will bless this marriage, that everything they do will succeed, that it will be a pleasant journey, that it will be a journey to remember. It will be a journey that will be spoken of as an example of the love between Christ and his church. We separate them from their backgrounds and we consecrate them into a new place, a special place in the family of God, a special place in the midst of God's people. We thank you for what you have done and we give you all glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Eddie, you are the man. And so it starts with you. Everything rises and falls on each. I was sharing the other day with Pastor Seth that when it comes to games, players win games. But when there's a lose or when there's a defeat, the coaches are blamed. Amen? And so everything starts with you. You are the man. God created the man before the woman. And so remember that God is counting on you. And you initiated this. And with God's help, I will make you succeed. Take this ring and put it on the wedding finger and say after me. I am the devil. I am Dab. Take me, Beatrice, bound to be my wife. And before God, and these witnesses, I promise to be a faithful husband. In Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Beatrice. Say, I, Beatrice.
I, Beatrice.
Take D.
Eddie Dabo.
To be my husband. And before God. And these witnesses.
I promise.
To be a faithful.
And a loyal wife.
In Jesus' name. Amen. The rings are symbolic of covenant. Amen. The God we serve is a God of covenant. And anytime he wants to do a new thing in the earth, he looks for people who are ready to enter into a covenant relationship with him. And through that covenant relationship, he manifests his glory. What we have seen now is a portrait of God's faithfulness and his goodness towards the two of them and towards all of you that are here. For those of you who are family that came from far and near, we want to thank you for coming and we want to thank you for being a part of this. They need your encouragement, they need your support, they need your prayers, they need you to stand with them, not just on this day, but throughout this journey. And I believe that with God's help and with your support, they will succeed. Amen. I'll ask the pastors to come so that we can surround them and pray with them. And rise up and stand for your hand. On this journey,
yes.
That they will be fruitful,
yes.
That God will bless them with children,
yes.
With a beautiful home,
yes.
With love,
yes.
ever-growing love, understanding, a deep passion, a deep understanding for each other. Let wealth and riches be in their home. Let them love the Lord. Let them produce godly children. This marriage will be faithful. This marriage will endure the test of time. This marriage will succeed. This marriage will excel. Nothing will stand between them. Nothing will be able to hinder them from fulfilling their purpose, fulfilling their destiny, fulfilling the reason for which they came into this union. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I want you to open your mouth and pray for them. Wherever you are, speak well of them. Bless them, honor them with your prayer. In the name of Jesus, Father, be at the center. Be at the center. Be at the center. Be at the center of this union, of this marriage, of this relationship. Bless them. Favor them. Cover them. Secure them. All obstacles with disconnected leaders from their past, with disconnected from all past relationships, with all forms of identity, with all forms of ruling in their background, in their father. Let their marriage be exceptional. Let their marriage be unique. Let their marriage be blessed. Let their heaven be open over their lives, their marriage, their union. With destroying all satanic plots, agendas, devices, committees, in the name of Jesus, we release miracles in this marriage. In the name of Jesus, let A excel, let beauties be fruitful, let supernatural favor, blessing, divine experience. Put your hands together. We want to seize this opportunity to invoke the mysteries of the broken body and the shed blood, the Holy Communion, for them as they begin this journey. Amen. That they are not going in their own strength. They are going in the strength of the blood of Jesus Christ and the strength of the covenant that God has with them. That as they eat and drink unto eternal life. That God will strengthen them, will feed them, and they will go in the strength of what they have eaten on this journey. Father, we consecrate the body and the blood. The word declares that on the night you were betrayed, you took the bread and broke it, gave thanks and said, "This is my body broken for you. As often as you do this in remembrance of me." The same night you took the cup and said, "This is the new covenant in my blood, shed for the remission of your sins. As often as you do this in remembrance of me." Take and feed her. The body of Christ broken, the blood of Jesus shed for you. Amen. Take and drink, blood of Jesus Christ shed for you. Gently. Put your hands together. You have to keep feeding her. Feed her with words of affirmation. Feed her with nice choice delicacies. Take her to nice restaurants. Amen. Make sure that she never lacks in any way. She's your first baby. Amen. Huh? She's the one and only, exclusive. So treat her special. No McDonald's, no Wendy's, no junk food. The choices, the best. Amen.
Amen.
Anytime we see her, let's see that she's looking glorious, looking fine, just like the father brought her to you, the brother brought her to you. Nice. Anytime we see her, she has to be looking better. Amen. Amen. Beatrice, please. broken for you. The blood of Jesus Christ, gently, gently, that's your baby. Put your hands together. Please make sure, anytime he comes home, there is food. Whatever he likes, do it for him. Amen? Feeding well. And feeding in all the different areas of need and feeding that he needs. There should be no starving whatsoever. He shouldn't go outside and eat anybody's food or drink anybody's soup or drink from anybody's well. You have enough to feed him, to take care of him by the grace of God. So even as you have fed him, before all of us, continue to feed him and make him the king that God has ordained for him to be, so you can also be the queen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. With all protocols observed, you may now kiss your bride. They say they didn't say it.
One more time.
You cannot say that you are an African man or a Mandinga. So there is no public display of affection. You should kiss her in public, even in church. Because that's your wife. And wherever you go, you hold her hand and you treat her well. You don't just do bedroom love. And then when you get out, it's like brother and sister. No, you have to always show affection publicly. Amen?
Amen.
And Beatrice, you can't be shy. Put his hands around you, just smile and enjoy the goodness of the Lord. The Bible says that enjoy the wife of your youth. Rejoice with the wife of your youth. It's very important. Amen?
Amen.
Otherwise, when you grow up, you become cranky old people. And when you see young people displaying love, you'll get jealous and angry. But don't allow that to happen. Enjoy each other. Enjoy each other's company. Enjoy each other's relationship. Enjoy each other's presence, celebrate each other, and cultivate the best in each other. What God has given to both of you is a great blessing. Don't let anything from outside destroy it. Don't let any man, any woman, any devil, any situation destroy it. Be thankful all the time. And every time the enemy wants to make you feel like you have done everything and it's not working the way you want it to be, believe today. Believe by today what God is doing today in this season, that we serve a God of miracles. And where your strength and his strength can't make up, God will make up for it and make it possible for you to succeed. The first miracle that Jesus did was at a wedding. And he turned water into wine. It doesn't matter how dry and blah things may get. So long as you allow him to come in, he will bring the spice back, he will bring the life back, he will bring the wine back, and give you the joy and the celebration that both of you need. It's a sacrifice. It's a path of sacrifice. Jesus gave himself. He gave his blood. The blood that you drank was a product of sacrifice. And in this relationship, somebody must be a fool. Hello? Somebody must always sacrifice to say, you know what, for God's sake, for love's sake, for family's sake, for your sake, I hold my peace. And if you learn to do that, God will really bless you along this journey. And there will be nothing that will be too strong to separate the two of you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hold each other's hands. By the power invested in me, I pronounce and declare you husband and wife. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, we declare that what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Let no woman put asunder. Let no devil, let no demon, let no situation, let no crisis, let no conflict be able to put asunder. We engage the hand of the Lord to be upon you on this journey. We engage your heavens to be open. We engage the voice of the Master to watch jealously over you both. We decree in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you will rise to the heights of life, that you will walk upon your mountaintop, you will walk upon your high places, you will excel on this journey. We declare divine immunity, supernatural preservation, supernatural protection, supernatural fruitfulness. Let the blessing of the Lord that makes rich and adds no sorrow be your portion. We bless you and we declare you blessed in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. We declare with thanksgiving, and everybody said amen.
Amen.
Receive now the latest and the hottest. They will be taking some pictures, and you may be able to take some pictures with them. And then right after that, we'll go into service this morning and bless the Lord and celebrate with them. I want to thank you all for coming, for your support and your encouragement. May God bless you, and may you continue to see this union developing into something beautiful and amazing. Thank you so much for coming. God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen.
You can take pictures with them, you can talk with them, some fellowship. We have some few refreshments just behind us. You can drink some water and some juice, and then after you can come straight to the
missing peace. So as long as I live, I love you. Heaven hold you. You look so beautiful in white. And from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. What we have is timeless. My love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in, with all my heart.